your life.
My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, divine light of the self. I welcome all of you for the summer story session today. Today we are listening to the story of Vamana Avatara, the divine incarnation of Bhagavan Vishnu called Vamana. First, let us offer namaskaram, respect to each other. The God in your heart, the divine light Atma Jyoti in your heart, and the divine light Atma Jyoti in my heart are one. Let us offer respect to the divine light in our hearts. Namaste. Let us chant Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu. First, I'll chant, then you can repeat. Offering our respect to Guru. Guru Brahma,
Guru Brahma,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Devo,
Guru Devo,
Maheshwaraha,
Maheshwaraha,
Guru Sakshat,
Guru Sakshat,
Parabrahma,
Parabrahma,
Tasmai Shri,
Tasmai Shri,
Gurave Namaha,
Gurave Namaha.
Welcome all the children and parents. Long back, there was a rishi called Kashyapa Rishi. Rishi is a sage. He is Brahmaji's son. Kashyapa Rishi had two wives called Aditi and Diti. The children of Aditi are called Devas, Devatas. The children of Diti are called Daityas or Asuras. The children of Aditi, Devatas, are always good natured. They want to help the creation. They want to serve the creation. They take care of the running of the world in terms of the seasons, the rain, the summer, the winter. Okay, taking care of living beings in the world. They want to contribute to the world. They are good natured. They are service oriented. They always participate in the creation process, in the sustenance process, helping all living beings who are born, who grow up, and who die throughout their life. Devatas, the divine beings. They are children of Aditi. And the children of Diti, they are called Daityas or Asuras. They are quite opposite of Devatas. They are evil minded. They want to destroy everything. Whatever Devatas created, they destroy. They want to destroy. So they create problem for all living beings. You can say, in a sense, they are like terrorists. Devatas and Daityas always fight with each other. Devatas fight with the Daityas so that they can help all the environment, all the society, all living beings. Daityas fight with Devatas to take control of the creation to destroy. So this fight between Devatas and Daityas will go on forever. Since Devatas help creation, Devatas help human beings, Devatas help all living beings, Devatas are good hearted, Bhagavan Vishnu always helps Devatas. Bhagavan Vishnu gives blessings for Devatas because Vishnu is the protector. Vishnu is responsible for the sustenance of the world. He protects. He takes care of Devatas. Devatas drank the amrita, the nectar, during the churning of the Milky Ocean. The nectar came, the nectar, Devatas drank the nectar, they became immortal, they don't die. Bhagavan Vishnu helped them to become immortal by drinking nectar, amrita. Asuras didn't get that nectar. The Daityas didn't get the nectar. But Daityas are more powerful. They are bullies. They are stronger. And they are more in number. They always create trouble for Devatas. Even though Daityas die, they are more in numbers. They are very strong. The army of Daityas always trouble Devatas. One of the Daityas called Bali Chakravarti, who is the grandson of the Prahlada, started becoming very strong. Bali Chakravarti ruled the world from Kerala. Today's Kerala was the capital of Bali Chakravarti. Bali Chakravarti became very strong. When the Bali Chakravarti became very strong, the Daityas became very powerful. His name is called Mahabali. Mahabali means very powerful. Mahabali. Mahabali became the king of Daityas and he started ruling from Kerala, the current Kerala in India. And Daityas became very, very powerful under his guidance. And he became a Chakravarti. Chakravarti means emperor. Who is a Chakravarti? Who will conquer many, many countries all over the world. It's called emperor. Bali became the Chakravarti. Mahabali became the Chakravarti, the emperor who conquered many countries in the world. He not only conquered many countries in the world, he conquered devatas also. Devatas live in heaven. He conquered the heaven also. He conquered the human beings. He conquered the devatas. And Indra, the king of devatas, had to run away because daityas conquered the heaven also. And daityas, under the guidance of Bali Chakravarti, created a lot of problem for everybody because they are evil-minded. They create so much of disturbance all over the world, destroy everything. They are bullies, very powerful bullies. Devatas were worried. They were worried about themselves. They were worried about the human beings. They were worried about the animals being troubled by the daityas. They prayed to Bhagavan Vishnu. Oh Bhagavan Vishnu, please save us. They prayed to Narayana. I'll chant, you can repeat after me. Narayana.
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 Hari Narayana.
Hari Narayana.
Hari Narayana.
Hari Narayana.
Swami Narayana.
Swami Narayana.
Satya Narayana.
Satya Narayana.
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 Narayana. So pleased with the prayer of devatas, Sriman Narayana appeared as Mahavishnu in front of devatas. Ask them, ask Indra, what do you want? Why are you praying to me? Indra says, Bhagavan, daityas have taken control of the earth. They have taken control of the heaven. Everybody is disturbed. The earth is getting destroyed. All living beings are disturbed. There's so much of pollution on the earth. The animals are being killed. The animals are crying. Every day, thousands of animals are being killed. The human beings are disturbed. They're mentally agitated. The heaven and earth both are disturbed because daityas have taken control of the world. When daityas are taken control of the world, the human beings also become evil-minded. They will also start harassing other people. And animals will find it very difficult to live. They get troubled. The rivers become polluted. The environment becomes polluted. The whole earth goes through a lot of trouble. Please save the earth. Please save the heaven. Devatas prayed Bhagavan Vishnu. Bhagavan Vishnu said, don't worry. I will take care of him. I will take birth as son of Aditi. And I will take care of Mahabali. Soon, Aditi gives birth to a child called Vamana. Bhagavan Vishnu is born as Vamana to Aditi. Vamana is a beautiful child, very radiant. When the child is born, normal child cry. But Vamana was born smiling. He knows when the Bhagavan takes the incarnation, even in the womb of the mother, when the child is born also, Bhagavan knows what to do. He knows. He smiles. He doesn't cry. the child grows up. When the child attains 8 years of age, father Kashyap Rishi and mother Aditi, they perform Upanayanam for him. Upanayanam means Yajnopavita, the sacred correct ceremony, and teach him Gayatri Mantra. When the child is 8 years old, the child is taught Gayatri Mantra, the sacred mantra. What is Gayatri Mantra? I'll chant, you can repeat after me. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yonaha Prachodaya. Gayatri Mantra is very, very powerful mantra. By chanting the mantra, the mind becomes pure. Surya Bhagavan, the God, gives intelligence, wisdom. This child Vamana, at the age of 8, he is called Brahmachari because he is not married. He got Brahmopadesham in the form of Gayatri Mantra. He has, his face glows, he is radiant. See, when the heart is simple, when the mind is pure, there is a lot of beauty in the face, the divine beauty. Vamana travels to the kingdom of Bali, Bali Chakravarti. Bali Chakravarti is performing one yajna offering to get more power. Daityas want more and more power, so they keep on doing some yajna offering to get more power. Vamana reaches the kingdom of Bali Chakravarti. Bali Chakravarti and his wife, they look at this young boy, 8-year-old boy, so radiant, so handsome, glowing with energy. There is divine energy in the face of the young boy. It's called Vatu. Vatu means young boy who is radiating divine light because his mind is so simple, mind is pure, the heart is simple, and he chants all the Gayatri Mantra and Veda Mantras. Anybody who looks at such a boy gets attracted, so attractive, so nice boy. Bali Chakravarti asks the boy, "Oh child, what's your name?" The child cutely says, "Vamana." Very nicely he says, "Vamana." Everybody is fascinated by his talk. "Oh my dear child, Vamana, why you have come here?" Bali Chakravarti asks. Then Vamana says, "I want a donation from you." Dana, donation is called Dana. Bali Chakravarti says, "What do you want?" Vamana says, "I don't want much. I want only 3 footsteps of land. I need little bit." My Bali Chakravarti starts laughing. "What? What are you asking? Your foot are this small. You are such a small feet. You want 3 footsteps of land? You are asking from whom, do you know? Bali Chakravarti, I am the emperor. I rule earth and heaven. You ask big land, I'll give the country for you. Why are you asking the small little 3 footsteps of land? Boy, don't you know whom you are asking? I am the emperor. Ask something more." Vamana cutely says, "I am not greedy. Bali Chakravarti, I just need 3 footsteps of land. Can you give me? I'm not at all greedy. I don't want big kingdom. I don't want big land. Just give me 3 footsteps of land. Then Bali Chakravarti says, okay, I'll do that. The Shukracharya, guru of Daitya, he gets suspicious about this boy. This boy must be some... Who is this boy? Asking for 3 feet. 3 footsteps. There must be some trick in this. He says, Bali Chakravarti, don't give him the land. There must be some trick in this. Don't give. This boy must be playing a trick on you. Who will ask 3 footsteps of land from Bali Chakravarti? There must be some trick in this. Don't give. Bali Chakravarti says, no, I have given a promise and I will not break my promise. I will give 3 footsteps of land to this boy. Let him take. Then he asks Vamana. Okay. So when you give something in earlier days, you'll say, you'll give water. Take water and drop water and say, I am giving. This is a sign of giving. So Bali Chakravarti takes his pot of water. And the pot of water and tries to pour water. Shukracharya becomes suspicious of this whole thing. He goes and sits in the nozzle of the pot. He sits in the nozzle as a fly. He takes the form of a fly. Shukracharya is a Daitya Guru, the king of, the guru of Daityas. He takes the form of a fly and goes and blocks the nozzle of the pot where Bali Chakravarti is giving water. The water is not coming out. Vamana smiles, the kid. He takes one dried grass and pushes that grass into the nozzle. It goes and hits the eye of the fly, the Shukracharya. Shukracharya's right eye is gone. He starts crying and suddenly starts crying and falls out. He has lost his eye. The Shukracharya, the guru of the Daityas, loses one eye because Vamana punches his eye with one grass. So Shukracharya says, no, please don't give this 1 foot of land to Vamana. This guy is not an ordinary kid. He must be some Vishnu who is coming in this form. He tries to stop Bali Chakravarti. Bali Chakravarti says, no, once I have given my word, I will stick to that. Then he gives 1 footstep of water. He drops water and says, I am giving you 1 footstep of land. Where do you want to keep your 1 footstep of footstep? Then Vamana smiles and keeps 1 footstep. And that one, Vamana starts growing big. The small kid starts growing big. And his 1 footstep becomes the entire earth. The whole earth is 1 footstep of Vamana. So Bali Chakravarti says, I am giving that 1 footstep. Entire earth, which Bali Chakravarti had conquered and made all human beings as slaves, is given to Vamana. Now human beings and animals are free now. So then Vamana says, I want to keep my 2nd footstep. Then he takes the 2nd footstep and keeps in the heaven. The entire heaven where devatas were ruling earlier and Daityas had taken control of that heaven. Now 1 footstep of Vamana covers the entire heaven. Brahmaji, who is seeing that Vamana's footstep coming to the heaven, he bows down with respect to Vamana's foot. And he offers water, the padyam, to Vamana's foot. He washes Vamana's foot. Second step of Vamana covers the entire heaven. So Bali Chakravarti says, I am giving heaven also. The heaven which Daityas had conquered now goes back to Vamana. So now all devatas are free. Otherwise, devatas had become slave of Daityas, heaven. The Vamana says, one more footstep is there. Where do I keep? There's no place to keep. The earth is covered. The heaven is covered. Then Bali Chakravarti says, please keep that foot on my head. Your feet is holy feet. Bhagavan Vishnu's feet. Bhagavan Vishnu's feet should touch my head. My head will become purified. I will be purified. Please keep that foot on my head. So now Vamana has grown. He has become infinite. The small boy has become very big. And that's why this same Vamana is called Trivikrama. Tri means three. Vikrama means conquered. He conquered the earth. He conquered the heaven. And he conquered the Bali Chakravarti. The emperor who had covered the earth and heaven. He conquers Bali Chakravarti. He keeps the third feet, the third step on Bali Chakravarti's head. So now Bali Chakravarti is purified. Vamana says, I am very, very happy with your dana. Dana means charity. You gave everything you conquered to me. And you stuck to your word. You stuck to your promise. You didn't go back on your promise. You kept your promise. That's why you will be known as Bali Chakravarti. You will be known for your dana, means donation. Your great heart, big heart donation. You didn't keep anything for yourself. You kept your word and you donated whatever you earned and to me. Now you go and you become the ruler of the Patala, the netherworld. So he makes Bali Chakravarti king of netherworld. And he says, I am very, very happy. Even though you are a daitya, even though you are demonic in nature, but you have so many good qualities. One good quality is you keep your promise. Whatever promise you have given, you keep it. Second thing is you are large hearted. You give, donate. You have donated everything you have earned. Donation. So that's why people in the world will remember your name. The people in the world will remember you. You will be known for your generosity. You will be known for your generosity. You will be known for your good heartedness and the promises you kept. Once in a year, people will worship you. People will remember you on the earth. So on every Deepavali day, during celebration of Deepavali day, people will light the lamp in their house in your name. That is called Bali Padyami. What is the purpose of lighting the lamp in your house on Bali Padyami day? The lamp is lit in the name of Bali Chakravarti to remember the great sacrifice which Bali has done. So his good nature, the promises he kept, that is remembered. Why do we light a lamp on Bali Padyami day? We remember Bali Chakravarti and pray to Bhagavan Vishnu. O Maha Bhagavan Vishnu, Give us good qualities of Bali Chakravarti. Give us the generosity to donate. Give us the ability to donate. Give us the strength to keep our promises. Let us have some good qualities of Bali Chakravarti. That's why we light lamp on the Deepavali day in the name of Bali Chakravarti, Bali Padyami. And people in Kerala celebrate a festival called Onam. They honor Bali Chakravarti on the day of Onam. Thus, Bali Chakravarti became a great being. He conquered the entire world, but he donated that also. And he got purified because Bhagavan Vishnu kept his feet on his head. Bhagavan Vishnu, who was a small boy called Vamana, became Trivikrama, who occupied the entire universe, the huge. This is the story of Bali Chakravarti. In a way, there is a meaning for this story also. Vamana means mana, the mind. Vamana means purified mind. In our mind, when the mind becomes pure, our mind becomes pure, the tiny, tiny boy called Vamana comes into our mind. Tiny boy. The God comes into your heart, which is pure. And that is called Vamana. He comes as a tiny boy in our heart. Then we say, we offer all what I have to you, God, Bhagavan, mentally. Then the tiny boy grows. He fills up the entire universe. This is a story of God realization also. We can realize God when we invite Vamana into our mind. And the Vamana becomes Trivikrama, he grows. So first God comes into our mind, then we realize God is everywhere. In the sky, in the water, in the earth, God is everywhere. All pervading reality is God, and that is called God realization. So all of us have to develop the qualities of Bali Chakravarti, the donation. We should learn how to keep our word, and we should invite Vamana, that God, into our heart, the tiny little God. But if you give little space to God in your heart, the God will occupy entire your being. You will start experiencing God everywhere. So this is the story of Bali Chakravarti. With this story, we'll conclude today. Let us chant the prayers. Asatoma.
Asatoma.
Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Tamasoma.
Tamasoma.
Jyotirgamaya.
Jyotirgamaya.
Mrityorma.
Mrityorma.
Amritam gamaya.
Amritam gamaya.
Om.
Om.
Shanti.
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 Lokah samastah.
Lokah samastah.
Sukino bhavantu.
Sukino bhavantu.
Lokah samastah.
Lokah samastah.
Sukino bhavantu.
Sukino bhavantu.
Lokah samastah.
Lokah samastah.
Sukino bhavantu.
Sukino bhavantu.
May all beings be happy. May all beings be free from fear. God bless us all. We'll meet tomorrow at the same time. Namaste. Questions, sir?
Okay. This is the show.